What is Robotic Process Automation or RPA in short? In this video you will get an introduction to Robotic Process Automation and its tools. In this video we will talk about four topics. Robotic Process Automation or RPA, RPA Tools, RPA Benefits, and RPA Roles. To make the topic of Robotic Process Automation easy to understand, I have a small example for you. Do you know the wheelchair method? This is when employees manually transfer data from one system to another. Like transferring data from an Excel file to SAP system. All such tasks are routine tasks that consume a lot of time. These are problematic, expensive, slow, and boring. Today many employees spend only about 40% of their time on something of high quality, and the rest is just routine tasks that are manually, rule-based, and in high volume. Employees who often have to perform such routine tasks often lose the sense of these activities and feel that they are mainly doing unimportant things and begin to yearn for tasks that really move the company forward. As a result, employees' productivity decreases and has a negative impact on the company. With our friends, the bots, we can automate these tasks and free the employees from them so they can concentrate on other things. RPA is a technology that is currently being widely used by companies, especially in the finance sector, because it involves a lot of routine work. With RPA, we can automate different types of documents and tools, such as Excel, Word, PDF, text files, but also web pages, ERP systems, Google Mails, create reports, and much more. Now we turn to the second point, RPA tools. UiPath, BluePrism, Automation Anywhere, and many other tools are used to automate processes that are always the same and require no human intervention. Here we have an example where an employee reads data from Excel and enters them into SAP. We can see that the amount of data is very large, and the employee can make mistakes about what he has already done, and in which row he is, and whether the entered data is correct. The process is just copy-paste, without making any decisions. Here is the modeling of the process, where all steps are listed in a flow diagram. For each step there is a corresponding activity in each RPA tool, where this can be automated, for example open Excel or open SAP. For each step in the process, we use one or more activities to automate the process. In the end, we have a bot that can perform this process, in the order as shown in the flow diagram. This bot can be started anytime to get the job done, without a human having to do it manually. We now know what RPA is, and what can be done with the RPA tools, but which processes are suitable for RPA? I am going to mention the most important criteria in deciding whether a process is suitable for RPA. Processes have to be in an electronic form. Process should work with stable systems, like SAP. Automation should generate savings. Processes should have a high volume. They should be mature and stable. Processes should have a low exception rate. They should be rule-based and need no human intervention. Highly manual and repetitive processes are the most suitable for RPA. Now we turn to the third point, RPA benefits. I will show you the main advantages of bots. Reliability. Bots can work effectively 24/7. Performance, execution time much faster than with a manual process approach. Error-free, less prone to errors and functions with accuracy and consistency. Cost reduction, reduces the size of manual personnel and thus lowers costs. Consistency, repeated tasks are executed the same way each time. Programming knowledge, programming skills are, almost, not required. Now we turn to the last point. RPA roles. RPA team. RPA team is made up of different roles. The main roles are business analyst, RPA developer, RPA controller, and infrastructure engineer. Business analyst must understand the process, business and technical requirements in detail. Evaluates whether processes are suitable for automation and plans the automation in detail. models the processes in detail, and optimizes them if necessary together with the SME. If you want to learn more about the business analyst role, see the video, RPA Business Analyst in my channel. You can find the link in the video description, RPA Developer. He is responsible for the development and implementation of process automation. This includes the design and testing of the automation processes, as well as support during the implementation of the RPA solution. If you want to learn more about the RPA developer tasks and skills, see the video, RPA Developer from the link in the video description. Infrastructure Engineer. He is responsible for all IT infrastructure and network issues, as well as for the server installations. He works on the RPA solution architecture and implementation, with a focus on IT infrastructure issues. He also acts as technical support for these topics in the event of corresponding incidents. RPA Controller. He is responsible for monitoring of the machines and the cases which are running on these machines. He informs the business analyst if a process is terminated. So we come to the end of the video. In summary, one can say RPA is an important technology that simplifies our working world and gives us more space to deal with important things and to develop ourselves instead of behaving like robots and not being able to learn anything new. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like and comment. See you in the next video.